this is Brushfire Wyndragon, and welcome back to my Kingdom for the Princess. I was trying to play Paper Bark this week, but my computer kept crashing, and finally it just started loading to a white screen, so I'll have to see what I can do about that. But I'll try to get that all recorded for a different day. You've probably noticed that there is a different intro this time. My friend Bandolera Roja on DeviantArt drew it for me. She lives in Australia. And I was intending on debuting it with Paper Bark, but it doesn't seem like that's going to happen this time. Since Paper Bark is an Australian game, so I thought that would be apropos, but it looks like I'm going to have to play My Kingdom for the Princess instead, since Paper Bark does not want to work. And here we are on the third island. The cracked ice is significantly stronger than it appears at first glance. You can walk on it, but there's no way the carriage will make it. You'd better reinforce the road with logs. Yes! Now you have a bottomless coffer that provides a constant source of gold. An enormous sawmill. You can now expand your large sawmill to an enormous sawmill, which produces 3 units of wood each minute of play. This is a pretty short one.
You expanded your castle.
Okay, let's see what I got. A brand new tower. Cool. Okay. The road to the river has been blocked by hugs. Huge piles of snow and ice. You will need a lot of resources in order to shovel the snow and then rebuild the bridges. To make the task easier, take possession of the fisherman's hut and gather the logs that somebody left behind.
You expanded your castle.
Okay. Ooh. A walkway. The road ahead is blocked entirely with rocks and snowdrifts. So think carefully about what to build first and what you can put off to construct later. Extra large farm. Okay, it produces 3 units of food. Thank you. somebody, hurry! There we go.
You expanded your castle.
Okay, let's see what I got. Ooh, trees and bushes. That looks nice. Ice-covered bridges. You cannot build a warehouse here, and without a warehouse, you will not be able to accumulate more than 20 units of each resource. So don't try to gather everything at once. And all done.
You expanded your castle.
Good. Oh, it's a tiny turret. Okay. Level 5. Ghosts and bears. Which path to insurmountable obstacles to tackle first? The ghost or the polar bears? The choice is yours. And now we can get an enormous warehouse and accumulate 80 units of each resource. Nice. Thank you.
You expanded your castle.
Nice. Let's see. Oh, another little turret. Tower on a tower. Okay. Level 6. There's a lot of wood in the north, and men and provisions in the west. You choose, you will need both. It looks like I've finished it this time. Oh, good.
You expanded your castle.
Of hope. On this level, it will be necessary to gather many resources and remove the boulders blocking the road. Almost done. There we go. Run! Level complete.
You expanded your castle.
Let's see. Oh, I got a row of stones to mark the walkway. Level 8. extinguished torches are scattered about the map. Light all mine. Spend your resources wisely, because you can't build a warehouse here. Oh, great. Come on, run, run, run! There we go.
You expanded your castle.
I expanded the castle, finally. Is that an outhouse? Or just a shed? Okay, level 9. Let's see. A very long and difficult path through rocks and ice awaits you. Start breaking through to the east as soon as you can get enough resources. Yes, finally. Level 9 done.
You expanded your
I expanded my castle and got mad. Oh, stovepipes. Cool. Level 10. It looks like there might be... this time. Oh yes, easy.
You expanded your castle.
I cut some cards. Oh, that one's sleeping. Okay. It looks like 11 is the last one. The road home. Finally, collect the keys to all the rooms of the castle and proceed through the portal. Yes, I did it in one try this time. I didn't finish the thunderstorm, I guess.
You expanded your castle.
Okay, how's it look now?
At last, Helen was home. It is good when someone who was lost without a trace returns, especially when that person is your only daughter. The joy that spread across King Olgird's face made him look 20 years younger.
His mustache is in the way.
He wanted to reward Arthur with half a kingdom and make him chief minister. But Arthur said, "What use is a kingdom without someone to help me rule it?" And so, he asked for Helen's hand in marriage. Helen agreed, for she had been head over heels in love with Arthur ever since Rocky Island. Her father gave them his blessing, and the whole kingdom celebrated their wedding for 3 days and three nights. And would you believe that the next morning, nobody had a headache?
Well, that seems apropos of nothing.
The newlyweds moved into Arthur's new castle. If the castle did not reach its full size during the game, you can replay the levels indicated in silver on the map and complete your castle. Thank you for your heroic deeds, and may we meet again in new adventures.
Hey, are you going to show me the castle? It is finished when you see a rainbow above it. Okay. Oh, I do have a rainbow. Oh, the castle is finished. All right, I'm a little disappointed I didn't get to play Paper Bark for you guys, but I hope you enjoyed this one. Thank you all for watching, and this is Brushfire Wyndragon signing off with a pretty rainbow.